So today I'm going to unbox this Ranger alcohol ink kit. I bought this kit from the Hobby Lobby and I spent around $25 on it. I never used alcohol ink before, so this is my first time, and I'm going to show you all the content of this box. There is some inspiration on the side of this box and also some contents in the back side of this box. Thus all our things are included in the kit, like alcohol ink, blending solution, blending tool, etc. Let's open this kit and let's see what's inside the box. So first of all, we have ink applicator tool with the 10 felt pieces, and that's a good thing. Let's open it. So here is a felt pieces and the wooden tool with the sign of Tim Holtz. The next thing, we have a clear stamp set, and I really like this design because this is perfect for the mixed media background. Another thing, we have a mini distress archival ink pad. Then we have these five things, which is like a metallic mixative and mini blending solution. And also we have three alcohol inks. One is a red paper, sunshine yellow, and a stream. And then we have 5 sheets of glossy cardstock, which is perfect for the alcohol ink. Then we have this acrylic block for the stamping, and this acrylic block is a little bit thinner. In the last, we have this instruction book, which has all the details about alcohol ink and photograph of each of the techniques throughout, and also in a multi-language, which is a very good thing. This instruction book is a very handy, and there is 4 different techniques they included. First is a August, monoprint, ombre, and a plaid. So now I am going to do first technique of this alcohol ink, which is August. I am going to stick this felt on an ink applicator tool, and then I am going to apply several color of alcohol ink, 2 or 3 drops of a mixative to ink applicator tool. This is my first attempt with the alcohol ink, so I'm so much excited to see the result. And then I'm just going to stamp ink tool directly on the glossy cardstock until it covered. I am reapplying this ink again on my tool. You just stamp it all over the cardstock and it's gonna be blend together. Add several drops of a blending solution to tool and stamp over background to blend. And to be very honest, it doesn't turn out very well. And now I am going to stamp the image with archival ink and let it dry completely. I'm going to use this archival ink pad, which I have already, so I'm not going to use this mini archival ink pad. Basically, I am just following all the instruction which is given in the booklet, and I don't like to stamp on this background because this background is too much busy for the stamping. The stamp is not clear just because of it's a new one, and honestly, I don't like this technique, the Agate's technique, and I'm not a big fan of this one, like, it's okay. So now let's move on, let's do another one. It's a monoprint technique. I have already my graph sheet down, and now I'm applying several colors of alcohol ink and 2-3 drops of mixative to graph sheet. You can also use any kind of the plastic instead of the graph sheet. And then I'm going to add several drops of blending solution over inks to blend. And then I'm going to swipe the paper glossy side down through the ink mixture, and then I'm going to lift it. Really surprised thing to see the final result, and here it is. It looks so gorgeous and so beautiful. I really like it. Now I'm just applying some colors on the leftover part. You can easily clean the graph sheet with the help of baby wipes, and now I'm going to do some stamping on it. I'm using my own stamp for the stamping. I bought this wooden block stamp from the Michaels, and if you want to see all the materials, then I'm going to put link in a description box so you can easily buy this material from that link. I really like this technique, and I'm going to use this one as a mixed media background. I really like to make some layers with the stamp and create some new design, so that's why I'm going to stamp it again with a different design, and this pattern, this butterflies comes with the kit. I really like this background. I'm in love with this card, and now I'm just going to play with some other alcohol ink for some more practice. So first of all, I'm going to apply this red paper alcohol ink on my felt, and I'm just randomly applying this alcohol ink, and then I'm going to add some blending solution, like 2 or 3 drops of blending solution. And then I'm going to stamp this ink tool directly on the top of the glossy cardstock. I'm going to cover entire cardstock with the same color. Then I'm going to add several drops of sunshine yellow ink and a stream ink on the top of this glossy cardstock. This ink dries very quickly and it's very satisfying to see the movement of alcohol ink. Just randomly adding several drops of all the alcohol inks on my cardstock. It's turned out really pretty. I just love the effect of this alcohol ink. So in this way, we can create vibrant layered background for a use on cards or a mixed media projects. And now I'm going to add several drops of this metallic mixative. This background turns out really, really pretty. So now I'm going to do another one. For that, I'm only using the red and yellow alcohol ink on a glossy cardstock. I'm going to use a lots of blending solution to blend yellow and red ink properly. You may get chance to win this Ranger alcohol ink kit. So for that you just need to check the description box for all the details of a giveaway. Team Holds alcohol ink from the Ranger are fast drying transparent dye ink specially formulated to create colorful effect on a non-porous surface. You can combine with the metallic mixative and a blending solution for a unique design and a unique stone background. So in this card, I am giving some movement of alcohol ink by adding blending solution on the top of the ink. I like this background, it turns out very pretty and very well, and I really like some of this design, and I'm going to do some more research about alcohol ink and I can create some beautiful design with this beautiful background with the alcohol ink. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, then make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't it already. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye.